happy Thursday, everybody. Mark again here at Weatherman Plus. Unfortunately, I'm bringing more bad news of what's going on with this possible Gulf hurricane coming in. Matter of fact, all the ensembles showing the strengthening leaving along the southeast of the lower 48, that has disappeared. I expect in the updates that this is going to turn red, showing at least 70% chance or more. And I think this is going to stretch even further west, potentially in towards Louisiana. So I'm going to show you all the latest information in this video. If you've never been here before, make sure you subscribe. I am all year along with my weather forecasting. We've been following the chances for this growth a month ago in the data and over 2 weeks ago in the model data. And we've been following this westward trend for a few days now. Matter of fact, you can see this morning that it's got a lot of convection. All this blue is a lot of convection, a lot of lift. And it's trying to form a surface low right over by Hispaniola. And it's still having problems because of land interaction. You can see we got an upper level low bringing some winds from the west to the east. So that's going to give it a little bit of shear as it travels to the west. But I'm still showing once it gets over here by Cuba, it's going to head north. So we literally have 4 days. We have 4 days from it being right here into these possible positions. Still showing that a high pressure is going to block this system by all of the weather models. And if it does go across, because the high pressure is taking a little bit longer to suppress the system, showing on the latest update, as it crosses over, it will come back again. We even have one crazy one that's going all the way around the lower 48, just bringing impacts to a lot of people. So I'm going to show you the latest information. Thank you for all the likes in yesterday's video, everybody. Y'all are literally saving lives. Thank you to everyone that hits a like on the video. Just caring about others in general. That's the best way to be. If you share the information, you share the video, you will double the chances for them to see it. So I appreciate all of y'all. Let's get into your information. Remember, there is going to be an update for this afternoon. The latest information from the Euro shows in 72 hours that it will continue going to the west instead of going by Florida, and it will go into the Gulf a little bit wider. Like we seen yesterday from the weather research and forecast model, this is going to go potentially further to the west of the center of the Gulf of Mexico. And that is the way it's looking. A little bit wider. I think we're going to get a bigger area to watch over here all the way to Louisiana. Plus, don't forget, the whole area of the Gulf from Louisiana and east is the warmest waters in the Gulf of Mexico. Matter of fact, all this white section you see here, this is approaching 90 degrees. All you need is 80 to sustain a tropical system. And we still got a deep ocean heat content right in the middle of the Gulf, where if it started strengthening and doing the upwelling effect, it would pull up warmer waters and it would not keep it somewhat at a weaker system. It would rapid intensify. Matter of fact, the latest information from GFS shows it would either be a hurricane or a major hurricane. When you look at the latest on the ensembles, you can see in 72 hours, all of them showing that it will still be something very weak, very deceiving of a wave. You don't even see these over here no more by Florida. As you go 4 days, it's going to start approaching that northward push, staying weak until the last minute. Right before 5 days is right when things is going to change. And I'll show you what this one is. This is what the GFS sees also in the latest update this morning, showing it comes right back again. Will not let it escape. After 5 days, this is where everybody's going to see this weak tropical wave blow up into something because of this stall. Potentially a hurricane, potentially a major hurricane. And now we're having possibilities of after landfall going out through the East Coast. And we still got one that's showing maybe it could curve towards Texas. But all of them are grouping up into this tight little area that your chance for formation would more likely be in that region. Now going by the ensembles, you can see with the Euro literally in 4 days showing it will be in that region. It will not be on the coast of Florida, on the East Coast of Florida. And as you go forward, showing more confidence that it will be right over here below Alabama, and everything north and east side would be getting the impacts. And that's just from landfall, because it's going to do more after it goes on land. After we go further, this is going past 5 days, showing it could tighten up even more and just do a little turn because of the high pressure pushing this towards Florida. And if it comes later and still revolves around the Gulf and stays there, then you can see that westward push. When you look at a Canadian, here's a Canadian in 4 days, and as you go forward towards the 5 days, showing the same thing. It could eventually curve right in towards Florida, getting pushed by that high pressure. And if it stays in the Gulf also after that, then you will see somewhat of a westward push. And the GFS in 4 days showing the same thing, but it could go west a little more first, according to the GFS, and go right towards Louisiana. So the latest trend shows that it will come in somewhat weak for the next 4 days, be very deceiving, look like a weak tropical wave that's just going to bring rainfall and bring you flooding. And then it's going to get blocked by that high pressure. If it's going a little further into the Gulf, the high pressure will push it a little bit further to the east, but then it still will block it. Then it's going to start strengthening. And if it don't leave out after a few days from strengthening, then it actually could get more of a westward push because the high pressure is going to revolve a little bit further to the north, and that could swing that to the west. You can see with GFS, this is a 0Z run. Now, this is what's important. The 0Z and the 12Z is balloon data runs. Those are the most accurate. That's when hundreds of meteorologists all around everywhere put up these balloons into the atmosphere and get readings from what's going on. And this is when you have the best data, is a 0Z and the 12Z runs. So this is a 0Z run from GFS, and you can see it showing right around 4 to 5 days, going to the Gulf, and starts strengthening up where you have a potential hurricane. And then you can see it stays there for multiple days, just bringing all that precipitation. The high pressure expands out and pulls that to the west and gets stronger and stronger the whole time. Anywhere from 4 days to almost 8 or 9 days of nonstop rainfall and winds. Now, when you go by the 6Z run, the latest update on GFS, it brings it in 72 hours right here, a little closer towards Florida, showing that it will strengthen up right before landfall. Most of these are showing a lot of impacts on Florida. Try to escape and go over. That's what the Canadian is seeing, that it will potentially go over. That's 5 days already. Still strengthening up where it impacts more states, but then it gets blocked and it don't let it leave. And it gets blocked by high pressure in the Atlantic as well. So it can't go further to the east, and it gets pulled further to the west, and it comes back again. A double hit on Florida and other states. Now, when you look at the Euro, it shows you how deceiving it could be. All the way to 4 days, bringing that wave right on the side of Florida. Get blocked by the high pressure in the Atlantic. So we're talking about a serious block here. Cannot go east. And just sits there and just spins on the latest run next to Florida all the way up to 10 days. Then it starts going to the west. Now, you can't really see what's going on because this is going past 10 days. So when you look at your pressure systems, I'm going to show you this, and I'm going to show you the control member so you can see what's a little bit further. So you can see how it stays very weak, very deceiving, not going to harm anybody, staying in that Gulf, staying weak all the way up to 10 days. Bringing a lot of rainfall. This is the best case scenario. The rest of them show it intensifying. Still, this is the best case scenario showing a weakening, but still a lot of flooding. Now, when you go by the control member of the ensembles, this takes it a little bit further than 10 days. You can see all that weakening all the way up to 9, 10 days. Then it starts strengthening after that because it's getting blocked. It's staying in the Gulf for so long in those warm waters. And it starts going towards Louisiana, just like we're seeing with GFS a little bit later with the Euro. Either way, it comes across and maybe comes back out and affects the East Coast. This could be a long-lived wave. We could be watching this for a couple of weeks. Now, the balloon data on the GFS is what's really disturbing. Best case scenario, you get a hurricane going towards Florida. And yes, that is one of your best case scenarios, because this one actually shows that after that, it could strengthen up to an even stronger, maybe even a Cat 3 or a Cat 4 hurricane going towards Louisiana and Mississippi. This we need to pay attention to, because with the deep ocean heat content, with the sea surface temperatures staying in the Gulf so long, this storm would blow up to something very big. Where it goes, we really don't know yet. It's still too far. We've seen a lot of moving parts. But what the trend is, it'll come in weak. It'll try and go to the east, get blocked by the high pressure building in the Atlantic, and it's going to get pushed back to the west. Now, other than this being a group of disorganized thunderstorms bringing a lot of rainfall, then posing a big threat as a hurricane eventually, like we see with the Euro, that literally is the best case scenario, unfortunately. When we look with the Canadian, it shows the other best case scenario where it won't be a Cat 3 or Cat 4 hurricane, just maybe a Cat 1 that could be going right into Florida and then go right around the coast. And still not really come out too far. It's getting blocked and getting pulled right up the coast. This could affect even more people. So it is all over the place. What's trending is these two locations. Right here on the coast of Florida and traveling west towards Louisiana. If it don't leave out in the very beginning. When you go by the GOES satellite, showing the same thing. Potentially could form up right there. Right on the coast right there of Florida. This is by the GOES satellite. And still just sits there and spins and strengthens right over there the whole time. Impacts are a little bit all over the place as well. All of them showing a crazy amount. This is with the Canadian showing it will start ranking up right over here by Florida. But it will bring it into Georgia and the Carolinas and portions of Virginia and potentially go out. This will affect a lot of people, also bring a lot of winds as well. This is one of your best case scenarios. When you look with the Euro, you're going for the next 10 days. Look how it just sit here and piles up and just revolves. Brings everything towards Florida and some of Georgia as well. When you go by the GFS, next 10 days, it brings it right here circling around, bringing a lot of precipitation. Look at that, that's 40-something inches for the panhandle of Florida. That's almost 4 feet. Of water and showing it could go right around just like the control member with the Euro as well and maybe more after that. That's just the first 10 days. It always changes. I'm just trying to show you a trend. The latest on the winds showing that run came through, that it would bring a lot of strong wind gusts towards Florida, Alabama, Mississippi, and Louisiana and start weakening down as it goes through Arkansas. The 6Z run that showed it going out and coming back still would bring a lot of high winds towards Florida and Georgia. When we go by the Canadian, which showed one of the best case scenarios, it brings all these winds towards Florida, Alabama, Georgia, and then going right back out and being a threat towards the Northeast. And when you go by Weather Prediction Center, the meteorologist over there is showing that best case scenarios, like we've seen with the Euro, it will sit there and spin and bring all this precipitation on Florida. All that orange is going to anywhere from 5 to 7 inches, and that brown starts going from 7 to 10. And I'm showing this could be more. This is only the next 7 days. Remember, this has the potential to be around for 10 to 14 days in the Gulf. Now, for a forecast, because I see a lot of people don't want to put up a forecast on that. I am going to show you what I see. I see this wave coming by in about 4 days, being very weak. Being very weak. It could be even a little bit wider and coming in this direction. And then as it goes towards a little bend back towards the east, towards Florida again, it could strengthen up potentially towards a tropical storm. And if it goes slow enough, it could potentially be a low-grade hurricane and try and go out to the east. Now, if it comes out quick enough, it could make it and might go up the coast a little bit. But if it stays slow and prolonged, it could come right back, get blocked by the high pressure, and then be an even bigger problem. Still, everyone in the Gulf and right along the Mid-Atlantic, y'all need to keep yourself on high alert because this is changing, but it is trending more into the Gulf. Now, I know this is very disturbing to a lot of you. This is very intense. I'm from New Orleans, Louisiana my whole life. I know what it's like living in the Gulf, and it could be very dangerous at times. I will update you this afternoon. Make sure you click that bell and select all so you get the latest information of what's going on with the system. And I'm going to update you this afternoon on that next wave still coming in the middle to late August. That way you know everything that's going on in the tropics. I appreciate every single one of y'all. I truly hope you have a very great day today. Stay alert to what's going on with this system. I cannot stress this enough. It's going to be very deceiving, very weak, but it's going to pose very serious and very big threats. Before you go today, remember, don't fear, even though this thing is looking very ominous and it's looking very fearful. Don't fear. God is in control. Psalm 112, 4 through 7. Unto the upright there ariseth light in the darkness. He is gracious and full of compassion and righteous. A good man showeth favor and lendeth. He will guide his affairs with discretion. Surely he shall not be moved forever. The righteous shall be an everlasting remembrance. He shall not be afraid of evil tidings. His heart is fixed, trusting in the Lord. Amen. Now remember, this is still not an invest. We still don't have a surface low. And so until they get that, they don't have an investigation of what's going on with this system and what could potentially happen, because we don't have a surface low. This is why I do these so early and keep you updated, because when they finally get one, people are going to wake up to literally days to prepare. And if you got to get materials, and if you don't have a lot of money, 1 week is not long enough. You need another paycheck. I wish the best for every single one of y'all. Remember, all glory does go to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope he keeps you safe every single day of your life and forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Have a great day, everybody. I'll see you this afternoon.